Imagine you have invested your time and resources into the hiring process and found that perfect candidate. Then the background check comes back with a red flag. Now what? Hello everyone, my name is Swati and welcome back to another interesting topic, which is again about background verification but with a different scenario. Yes, so in this video, we'll talk about how to handle a failed background check like a pro. This video will equip you with knowledge and strategies to navigate this tricky situation calmly and effectively. So we'll break down the different types of red flags, outline clear action steps you can take, and provide valuable insights on how to make informed decisions based on the information at hand. So hit that play button and learn how to turn a failed background check into a positive outcome for your business. A failed background check means the results of the background screening report returned alerts on a job candidate, such as criminal conviction, a suspended license, or a positive drug test. Although you may receive an alert on the screening results as a failed background check after a job offer, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you should not move forward with the candidate. There could be many reasons why a background check failed. In fact, there are lots of things to consider before deciding not to hire a candidate, including the job responsibilities of the position, your company policy, applicable industry regulations, and federal and state laws. But when deciding whether to hire a candidate based on what was found on their pre-employment background check, it's important to follow certain steps as an employer. So while conducting the BGB process, either directly or through third-party agency, the company must ensure that it complies with its contractual obligation to the employer as regards data privacy, obtaining the employee's consent. For this purpose, it must ensure that its onboarding documentation and other processes like policies and processes such as disciplinary policy have the BGB process built in from the outset and are in line with it. These will also have to consider the requirements of law which regulate the collection of personal and sensitive data. The first reason is about the criminal background check, which may reveal misdemeanor convictions, violations or infractions, or arrests that didn't lead to prosecution, acquitted charges, or charges that were dismissed. Pending criminal cases may also show up on a criminal record check, and if the candidate has a criminal history, there are several factors that may impact an employer's hiring decision, like industry-specific regulations and the type of role. However, employers must be sure to comply with federal laws and guidance, as well as applicable fair hiring laws if they decide against hiring a candidate based on the results of their background check. The second reason is about the motor vehicle report, that is MVR, or a driving record check. Searches a candidate's driving history for traffic violations, license status, and type and vehicle-related criminal charges. A failed background check may reveal unsafe driving practices or a suspended license. Checking an MVR can help employers avoid any legal or insurance consequences that could arise should the employee get into an accident on the clock or while driving a company-owned vehicle. Now, on the third reason, what happens if a background check can't verify your employment history? This has become a common practice where candidates have lied on their resume about the work experience. An employment verification can help confirm that what a candidate puts down on their resume or application is true or not, including the previous job titles, dates of employment, and many other details. If discrepancy arises, this could mean that the candidate was not truthful about their background, or even that they do not have the necessary experience for the role. Recently, education verification helps employers confirm a candidate's education, degree, training, or certifications. A failed education verification may show discrepancy in the information provided by the candidate, which may include invalid or missing academic credentials. In certain industries like teaching, a specific degree may be required by law. Running an education verification can help employers to verify all these details. Now, lastly, a pre-employment drug screening can help employers test for the presence of certain prescription and illicit drugs. A failed drug test means one or more results were positive, indicating the presence of such substances. In these cases, an employer may choose not to hire the candidate, especially in regulated industries or where impairment on the job could create a liability. In states where individuals may legally use marijuana for medicinal purposes, employers may wish to consult with their legal counsels before taking adverse action on the basis of a failed drug test. Regulations concerning drug testing and hiring decision vary from one location to another, so employers should follow applicable state laws and the advice of legal counsel. It is commonly observed that many companies safeguard their interests by having a conditional clause in the employment agreement to the effect that the appointment of candidate may be subject to termination in case of a failed BGB report, which is a good business practice. While termination may seem like the best option available to the employer, some companies even go to the extent of blacklisting the candidates. However, such terminations are not simple and it comes with a cost, as failed BGB requires investigation by the company before initiating the termination process or imposing any form of punishments. So when you face challenging hiring decisions, there are some steps to consider to handle such cases of a failed BGB report. In the first step, a written background check policy should guide your hiring decisions. Effective background check policy should be consistent, current, and comprehensive. And if your policy meets these standards, it can provide reassurance that you are treating potential employees fairly, complying with legal regulations, and responding appropriately to contingencies. Secondly, if based on the results of a background check, you are considering to terminate a job offer, you must first inform the job candidate with a pre-adverse action notice. This notice is a requirement of the FRCA and should contain an explanation of the adverse information you discovered and a copy of background check and a summary of right. Thirdly, you must give the candidate an opportunity to dispute the results of background check and if there are any inaccuracies or provide additional context. Fair hiring laws in some jurisdictions may include a specific amount of time for this step, typically between 5 to 10 business days. In the next step, your final hiring decision should be in alignment with your company's written background check policy. You may want to incorporate EEOC guidelines for conducting an individualized assessment. The EEOC's nature test suggests employers consider the nature of the offense, the time that has passed since the conviction, and the relevance of the offense to the position. In the last step, after the waiting period has elapsed, if you decide not to move forward with the candidate, federal law requires sending a final adverse action notice. This notice must inform the candidate of your reasons for the decision and their right to dispute it. The notice must also include an option for the candidate to request a copy of background check within 60 days. If the employer used a consumer reporting agency to perform the background check, the notice should include the agency's contact information and a statement that the employer made the hiring decision. You should keep a copy of the notice and any attachments sent with the notice for your records. That's all in this video. I hope I'm able to clarify your concerns in regards to how to handle if BGB fails for an employer. If so, then please share your valuable feedback in comment section and also subscribe the channel to get connected with HR Administ for such useful contents.